Very good morning to all my dear students. Am I audible clearly?
Yes, sir.
You can reply in the chat box. Yeah, very good. Am I audible? Yeah, oh, very fine. So today we will be looking for the subject graphics design and modeling. In the last class, due to some official work, some other people have taken the class. Okay, so how many participants do we have? 27, okay. And the list I have received for GDM subject, it is around 67 or 69. Okay, anyhow, I am expecting very soon the students will join this class. So first, what I will do, I will go for a fast recap of what we have seen till now, okay? And then I will start a new topic, that is your projections of solid, or methods of projection and theories of projection. If in between you have any doubt, you can ask me, okay? I'm here to clear your doubts. So you can type in your chat box whatever is your doubt, okay? Because if so many person will speak at a time, so it will be very difficult for me to understand and clarify your doubts. So let's start. Yeah. Graphic communication. What is means by this term graphic communication? And on the right hand side, you can see there are two images. One, you can see a big crane machine standing just next to one glass tower is there. And one more figure you can see in the screen where you have some set squares, some instruments, okay, drawing pencils and some drawing sheets are there. Okay, so what are all these things? What do you think about these pictures? Any one student, can you speak it out? After looking this picture, what has come to your mind? Yes, anyone?
Architecture.
Okay, I'll tell you. Here, there is one crane machine who is helping to build a glass tower. And on the right hand side, there are some drawings and some drawing instruments are there. Okay, so basically any idea or any concept, whatever is coming to your mind, one student is typing, is this section B, ECE class? Yes, you have entered section B class. Because right now it is English subject. It means you have entered into the wrong class. This is a GDM class for B section, those who have opted for graphic design and modeling. And I hope all the participants here are those only who have opted for GDM subject. So whatever the ideas come to the mind of an engineer or designer, okay, first they put it on some piece of paper. Okay, then that design, using that basic idea, they do some calculation and determine some dimensions for that to bring it to the final drawing. Okay, now we will see what is this drawing, what is this graphic communication, each and every term we will see for better clarification. Okay, so what I can say, a drawing is a graphical representation of an object. Okay, it is a graphical representation of an object or a part of it. And it is a result of creative thought by an engineer or a technician. Okay, whatever the idea comes to your mind, so any time mind is active, suppose you are sitting in classroom or you are going somewhere in a vehicle, some ideas will be coming that I can design this, I can design. There should be this something like this, which can improve the functionality, or that can be a new creative things. Okay. So whatever you bring it on the paper, that is called as your drawing. Okay. When one person sketches a rough map in giving some direction to another, this is also graphic communication. Okay. We are conveying some messages to each other. So this one person sketches a rough map on a piece of paper, that is also a graphic communication. So what we can say, graphic communication involves visual material to relate ideas. Okay. It is a communication method which involves visual materials to relate ideas, drawings, photographs, slides, and transparencies. Right now, I'm using PowerPoint presentation slides to teach you. Okay. In our time, our professors were using those transparencies. Okay. But motto is same. Motive is same. What is that motive? That we want to teach you using some graphical text or figures or whatever the representation that we are using. Okay. Just for clarification of the idea that I want to transfer from my mind to your mind. So any medium that uses a graphic image to aid conveying a message or instruction or an idea is involved in graphic communication. So this is basically what I would like to tell you about, what is this graphic communication is. Okay. How we can transfer our idea to from one person to another person. Like if you will see in earlier days, okay, I will come to that point also, how those people, when there was no language to communicate with each other, so how people were communicating with each other. So one of the most commonly used form of graphic communication is drawing. Okay, in the first hour, I will be going for a fast recap. Once again, I'm telling you, those who are joining late, and then after that, we will start with the projection methods. So technically, a graphical representation of an idea, concept, or an entity which actually or potentially exists in life is called as your drawing. Okay, I'm telling you about drawing. Okay, drawing is the oldest form of communication. It is the oldest form of communication dating back even when there was no verbal communication. Okay, when there was no language to communicate with each other, by that time, drawings are being used to convey the messages. Okay. The drawing itself is a way of communicating all necessary information about an abstract, such as an idea, concept, graphic representation, whatever I have told you. Maybe it is a machine part or architectural building or any tools. Okay, anything, or any PCB board, whatever, any circuit design if you want to. So those things can be done also using this drawing. Okay. So I have used the term drawing long before the words were written. Okay. Even by that time also, drawings were used. Ancient times when there was no language. Here on the left hand side, you can see one picture where hunters are hunting some animals. Okay. These diagrams or these figures were taken from the caves, old caves drawn on the stones. So why I'm showing you this figure? I'm showing you this figure to tell you that in earlier times when there was no language to communicate, people were using this graphic language to communicate with each other. Like on this figure, you can see one teacher is there who is teaching their students like it was done in your old Gurukul times. Okay, so these all are graphical representations that still can be found in some older caves on the stones. Okay. Now, I have used the term called drawing. Now, drawings are also of two types. It can be artistic drawing. It can be a technical drawing. Now, what is artistic drawing? Let's see it first. Artistic drawings range in scope from the simplest line drawing to the famous paintings. Okay, there are many famous paintings made by different famous painters. Okay, so artistic drawings are like that. Regardless of their complexity, okay, they are used to express the feelings, the beliefs, the philosophies, and the ideas of the artist. Okay. So in order to understand the artistic drawing, it is sometimes necessary to understand first the artist. Because behind their drawing, some information, some beliefs, some philosophies are hidden inside it. However, if you will see on the right hand side here, I have written this technical drawing on which we will be focused, okay, because this is a technical course. So the technical drawing is not a subtle or an abstract. It does not require understanding of its creator. Only thing that you need to understand is that, what is that technical drawing? Okay, it means a technical drawing is a mean of clearly and concisely communicating all the necessary informations to transform, point to be noted, all of you listen carefully, to transform an idea or a concept into reality. Okay, so now we can say a technical drawing is a mean of clearly and concisely communicating all the information necessary to transform an idea or a concept into reality. Okay, so this is the definition of a technical drawing. Okay, therefore, these drawings often contain more than just a graphical representation of its subject. Now, what are those more things? It can be your dimension. All the parts will be given your dimensions. Of what material it is made up of, what process do we use to manufacture it. In an engineering drawing, each and every details will be written inside it. So this is about the comparison of your artistic and your technical drawings. Now, this examples I have taken on the left hand side, you can see one very beautiful scenery is painted. You can see blue mountain, blue skies, mountains, greeneries all around. And in the second figure, you can see one river is there, bridge, lamppost, trees are there. So these all are your artistic drawings. However, if you will see on the right hand side, what you will see, you have one gearbox. Okay, in the foreground, you have a three-dimensional picture of the gearbox. On the background portion, you can see the detailed diagram of each and every component of this gearbox is drawn here. What will be the dimension, where it will be placed, what will be its quantity, each and every detailed information is given over here. Okay, in the first drawing, at the bottom location, you can see I have picked a simple component drawn in three dimension. Here you can see dimensions are only given. Okay, in the last class, Vinay sir has told you what is the meaning of these symbols. Like phi, can anyone tell me what is this phi? This phi, what it is representing?
Diameter.
Here you can see one phi symbol is there. A circle and it is cut by a straight line. What it is representing actually?
Diameter.
Yeah, it is representing diameter. Yes. And R is the radius. Okay. So these are the different symbols that are normally used. And why I'm asking this again, because in your viva examination, this can be asked. What that phi is representing, how you will represent the radius. Okay. So each and everything, whatever we are focusing, you must keep in your mind because those things can be asked in your viva examinations. Okay. So this is the example of what is your artistic drawing and what is your technical drawing is about. Again, it is coming the definition of graphics that we have already seen. Okay. It can be defined as a graphical language that gives you a precise pictorial expression of engineering structure and is used to make communication possible between, okay, possible between designers and other people. Okay, suppose you are buying any new component, like any exercise equipments you are going to buy. Okay, those who are willing to do gym at home, or suppose you are buying any mobile phone, or you are buying any refrigerator or washing machine, inside that you can see the in the manual, some drawings are also available there, where we need to do some assembly of the different components. Like suppose you have bought some gymming equipments. So in that, with part numbers, the drawing is given in detail so that it can give you the communication between the designer and other people. Other people is end users, how we can connect them and we can use it for them. So this is regarding that. Engineering graphics usually provides detail that can be derived from engineering calculation. Okay. So in this drawing, you have seen some dimensions are given. The thing is how those dimensions are coming, that you will see in the later stage of your BTech course, maybe in second year or third year. All those dimensions are coming from some calculations. Okay, some design equations are there. Solving those equations, we obtain those dimensions. Okay, but here we are not focusing on that. We are only focused on how to use that AutoCAD software to draw these drawings. Okay, so it helps to convey idea to the people, convert concepts into reality if draft, illustration or drawing follow universally accepted codes, criteria and conventions. So we have to follow certain standards, we have to follow certain codes, criteria and conventions. Okay, so then only this final engineering drawing is coming to your drawing sheet. Okay. Now, what is this purpose of technical drawing? You all must understand what is the need of these drawings. Okay, so to appreciate the need of a technical drawing, one must understand the design process. Okay, now what is this design process meant by? It is a process. It is a process, orderly process, systematic procedure used in accomplishing a needed design. Okay, so any product which is to be manufactured or fabricated, assembled, constructed, built, are subjected to any type of conversion process must be designed. Okay, for example, a house that is built, okay, or a bike you are driving, or a car we are driving. Okay, it is it can be made by so many different streams or different domain of engineers, like the houses are made by your civil engineers. Okay, those sanitarian people, they should know about this technical drawing so that they can understand the piping or the drainage system of the city. Okay, likewise, somehow or in different way, we all are connected with all the domains of this engineering. So if in one word I have to say about your the subject, that is your GDM, graphics and design modeling, we have to say, we have to think and analyze. What we have to think? Question is coming to your mind. As we have discussed in the previous classes also, that to represent any 3D object, suppose here I have one water bottle in my hand. Okay, this is a 3D object. If I have to represent this in two dimension on a piece of paper, so I have to think, if I'll see it from the front side, how it will look like. If I will see it from the top side or left side or right side, how it will look like. Okay. And suppose you have been given those 2D representation, okay, as of the workshop floor space, and you are been asked to fabricate that component, then you have to analyze how these drawings we can correlate to build a 3D object and vice versa. So GDM will give you how to think and analyze for any object that is to be designed or fabricated. So takeaway point of these slides I have taken in this one. So drawing is a basic form of communication in technology and industry, okay? It expresses the idea, conveys specific information. Now, information in what term? Information in terms of your dimension, information in terms of your material of which it is made. Okay, information in terms of those manufacturing processes, information in terms of the assembly of the components, every information. So it expresses the ideas, conveys specific information, by means on geometric shapes, lines, dimensions. It is a universal language. See here, if you are on the earth or you want to go and meet some people on some other planet, then still this you can say it is a universal language. Okay, then no need to study about this any English language or Hindi or Telugu or Java or C++. Okay, it is a universal language. You have to just show them the drawing and you have to make them understand. They will understand it. Okay, so it is a universal language that improves communication and eliminates costly errors of interpretation with drawing convention. Okay, drawing is the main method of communication between all persons concerned with design and manufacturing of the components. These things you have to keep in your mind, this keyword, design and manufacturing of the component. Okay, it is a communication between whom? Between all the person. Okay, so those persons who were concerned with your design and manufacturing of the components. So this is the takeaway points, what we have discussed till now. Now, I will come to the course outcome of your subject. What will be the course outcome? At the end of this course, the students should be able to identify AutoCAD 2D commands and their projections. Okay. Now, what is this AutoCAD? As I have told you, there are many CAD softwares. What is this CAD? Computer aided drafting. Whatever the drawing you have seen here, okay, those we can draw on computers. So this CAD stands for computer aided design. And AutoCAD is one of the basic software through which any designing designer start their designing career. Okay, this is the basic alphabet of your designing. Like we first learn ABCD, then we try to frame it, your words, then sentences. Okay, like this, if anyone wants to make career in designing, they start with this software, that is your AutoCAD. Am I audible now? One students are saying that there is some issue with
the audio.
Is it clear to everyone?
Yes,
please type in the chat box. Clear, sir. CS, you can type. Okay, I can see here many students are writing that it is clear, sir. Now, my voice is clear to everyone? Yeah, very good. Ruchita, it is now clear. Is it now clear? Okay, so we were discussing about the course outcomes. Course outcomes, at the end of this course, students, what you will get from this course? Okay, so you will identify what are the 2D commands used in this AutoCAD software, how to draw the projections, okay, apply different 3D commands, okay, in whenever you are drawing something, you can draw 2D as well as the 3D component. So first you need to learn what are the 2D commands, then you will learn how to draw the projections. Okay, we will apply various 3D commands and Boolean operation. Now, what is this Boolean operation? We will see it afterwards. Just keep in your mind. Suppose I have to join any component or subtract any component. So there are certain operations that we can perform while using the 3D version of this software. Okay. So those are called as actually Boolean operation while doing the modeling in 3D offset. The third course outcome is you can construct simple components. I have written here mechanical, but we can you can draw any component, okay, like pulley, springs, and we will allot you some project also of your choice. Whatever you want to draw, we will help you at the end of this course how to draw those 3D figures. Okay, now differentiate between what is orthographic projection, what is isometric projection. These words might be new for you people. Orthographic and isometric. Okay, anyhow, sir has discussed in the last class, but we will see it in details today also when we will be going with the methods or theory of projection. Then we will see in detail what is this orthographic projection and what is isometric projection. And finally, we will evaluate, or we will help you to do a team project. Okay, we will make a group of 4 to 5 students, and of your choice you can select any object, and we can help you to draw any component in 3D, and that will be considered as your project, final project. So this is the course outcome of this subject. Before starting any subject, we must know what we are going to learn out of the subject. Okay, so these are your course outcomes. Now, course content, what is the syllabus? I'll tell you what is the syllabus. We'll start with your introduction to computer aided drafting. Okay, in this we will see, we will start with basics of your engineering graphics that you are looking now, like what are the different types of lines, what are the methods of giving the dimension, theories of projection, okay, element of projection, plane of projection, methods of projection. These are the basics or the starting point of your engineering graphics. After telling you these things, then I will move on to your AutoCAD software. I will tell you the interface of the software. What are the basic 2D commands used? Draw commands, modify commands. There are different category of commands. Okay, how to do the page setup, how to do the setting for your printing, how to set the limits, everything inside the software. We will see those things once we will finish the basics of your engineering drawing of graphics, which includes these points. Okay, so this is your unit number one. In your unit number two, you will see the 3D modeling using this AutoCAD software, in which we will be using geometric primitives, some very useful commands like extrude, revolve, sweep, loft. Now when I'm telling you these things, these all things may be new to you people, okay, but when you will be using it on your computer, I will instruct you how to do that, okay, then you will find these things very, very interesting. And at the beginning only I'm going to tell you people, if you are regular to the class lectures and the instructions that we are giving you, regularly submitting the assignments, okay, or whatever the experiments that we call or class activity we will be doing, it is a very interesting subject, not only for scoring good in your this BTech course, but after your BTech also this subject will be very useful somewhere at some place. Okay, this will help you in your engineering career. Okay, not only this for scoring good marks only, I'm telling you. Okay, so this is a very practical subject that will be somehow very helpful for all of you. So these are different 3D commands or Boolean operations. Okay, we will see in unit number two, using these commands, how to build small components. We will start with simple components. That's why we have written here pulley, spring, and simple assemblies. So these things we will consider in your unit number two. Now coming to unit number three. In unit number three, we will see the conversion. Conversion of your pictorial view. Conversion of your pictorial views. Now what are your pictorial views? Orthographic views and isometric views. There are two views. Orthographic views, isometric views. In orthographic views, just for information I'm telling you, we will go in detail when we will be studying this unit number three. All your front view, side view, top view, whatever we are using this term, that will come under your orthographic views. And isometric is your 3D view of any component and vice versa. So whenever any 3D component is in front of you, how to draw that in 2D on a piece of paper, That is your orthographic drawing. And when suppose 2D views are given and you have to think how this 3D view you can draw, that will be your isometric view. So this vice versa conversion, we will study in your unit number 3. Okay, in this everything will be considered, like your theory of projection, different views, what are the different views, what are the different methods, first angle projection method, third angle projection method. Okay, but in our country, we generally use this first angle method of projection. So these things we will study all about this orthographic and isometric views in your unit number 3. Okay, after this, unit number 4. Here we will see projection of solids. Rather, I will say simple solids we will study in your syllabus. Suppose any component is there, if it is, what are the different reference planes, what is horizontal plane, what is vertical plane, parallel planes, profile planes. Okay, in different orientations also, we will tell you about projection of solids. We will see it in detail in your unit number 4. In unit number 5, it is completely your project. Okay, that is creation of any engineering model. Whatever you have learned through these 4 units, you have to utilize those skills, and then we will create a simple models, engineering models of wireframes, what is shaded solids, mesh topology. Okay, so using those solid modeling tools that you have learned till now, using those things, it will be a teamwork that you will see in your unit number 5. So this is the entire content of what you are going to study in this subject, that is GDM. So I have told you about the course content, and I hope you must find it very interesting. So sometimes this question is coming to the mind of many students, like especially ECE or computer science or different branch students, why do we need to study this subject? So in one or few lines, I would like to tell you that this is a very multidisciplinary world. This world is very multidisciplinary. What is the meaning of this multidisciplinary is actually the true nature of real world. Academically, you need to study subjects of your chosen domain, like whatever the branches you have selected. Okay, but in first year, some subjects of other domains are also taught to you to give a glimpse of other domain, which is very essential in later in your life to function as an engineer in your own chosen domain. Okay, suppose any electronics engineer or computer engineer has to design any CPU. Okay, on your PCB board, there are thousands and millions of transistors or different electronic components like resistors, capacitors, and so many things are there. So how you will assemble it? You will see some lines are drawn on those boards. Okay, if some line will be wrongly connected to different lines, then short circuit will happen. So for those things also, you need to learn any drawing software. And this AutoCAD is the basic fundamental software of any CAD package, any drawing software. If you know this, you can use any drawing software. Okay, so this is regarding your multidisciplinary or the real true nature of this real world. You all must, in the first year of your engineering, some glimpse of the subjects of other domains are being taught, because in the later when you join in the industry, it will be helpful for you people. Okay, now on your screen, you can see on left hand side, one scooter is there, the actual real figure of a scooter. Okay, it is normally, you can say, if you that term is in your mind, that this is your isometric projection or the realistic view of the component that is actually in front of you. While on the right hand side, on this screen, you can see these are the wireframes. Okay, in wireframes also, suppose this scooter is here and you are looking on this scooter from this side. Standing and looking onto this scooter from this side, the arrow marking that you can see here on the screen. Okay, what you will see? You will see this view. let me change the color. You will see this view. This is the front view of your scooter. Likewise, when you will see it from the top side, this way, magenta color you can see. This will be your top view of the scooter. These will be your two side views. This is your back view. And this is your, again, a different isometric view. Okay. So this I have given one example. It is related to the automobile sector. I'll show you a few more figures so that it will give you some idea. Here on the right hand side, you can see drawing of a flat. Whenever you have to buy any apartment, okay, what you do, you go to some builder apartment office, and initially they will give you some prospectus. In that prospectus, the 3D representation of their entire apartment is drawn like this. By looking at this, you can clearly understand that where is your entrance, where is your bedroom, master bedroom or kitchen, or where is your balcony. Okay, each and everything you can see here in this 3D representation. Okay, likewise in that prospectus, you will see this 2D representation also. This is called as your plan of the floor. Okay, where you can see each and everything. This is your entry, this is your, on the left hand side, you have laundry, then you have living room, then you have kitchen, bathroom, bedroom two, master bedroom, each and everything with dimension you can see here, like it is written in square feet. Okay, each and every room or everything is having some dimensions. So this is where you can see, I have shown you the example where it is used in civil engineers. Okay, so this is the 2D representation of a flat or an apartment, or this top view. This is basically the top view. When you will look this apartment from the top side, you can get an idea like this. This is also called as your plan of the apartment. Okay, now here, can anyone tell me what is this?
Water
chat
plan.
Box, you can type.
What is this? Patrick.
After looking at this figure, what is coming to your mind? Water plant, very good. Or any plant, it can be any chemical plant as well. Okay. Like you can see here, there are so many components connected with your pipelines. Okay, somewhere reactors are there. Some specific symbol here, you can see these are pressure gauges, or many sensors will be located to tell you what is the temperature at this location. There can be some cooling towers. Okay, so this is the layout of your any plant, any industry, okay, any chemical process industry. So again, if you want to set up your own industry or any plant, again, it will be very helpful. Okay, you can easily pick, ready-made components are available in any software. You have to simply click on this, I want a reactor like this. It will show you that we have some samples of reactor like this. We have some samples of compressor like this, symbols of these pressure gauges and your temperature sensors are there. Okay, likewise, cooling towers, each and everything. So how you can assemble them, how the different layouts, where it will be located, how they will be connected. Okay, for efficient workflow to happen. So this example I have shown you for chemical engineers and for those person who wants to lay out their own company, their own startups. Okay, so coming to your electronics part, I have taken a simple drawing. I don't know much about these electronic circuits, but in this you can see some electronic components are there. This is representing your battery, this is your resistor, maybe this is transistor, or this is your capacitor. Okay, so how you will draw that circuit diagram? Okay, so this is where you can use this software as an electronics engineer to draw the circuit board. Okay, where you, these components will be readily available for the electronics license of that software. Okay, and using that you can easily draw these diagrams. So this is how, where this is useful. As I have told you during that chemical plant diagram I have shown, that ready-made components are available in the software. Like here you can see one tower is there, evaporator, centrifugal pump, fan, blower is there, okay, compressor. Many components are used for setting up any drawings. So some of the ready-made components are also there inside a specific softwares. Okay. Now coming to CPU, this we all have seen that this is a CPU of a computer. Okay, suppose as a computer engineer or IT engineer or any other engineers also, it comes under your electronics also, okay, and electrical also. Suppose you want to design a new different kind of this CPU, which will be very compact in shape, but inside that compact device, you have to assemble so many things like fan, floppy disks, these things are outdated, but still you have so many things to get it assembled inside your CPU. So first you have to see, you cannot directly went for fabrication or building that. First you have to see it inside a software. What dimensions that I want to keep for my CPU? Okay, what are the dimensions of my ready-made available motherboard or power supply, SMPS, your system fan for cooling, your processors, your RAM modules, how and where you will effectively install it to make or to design a new CPU. So there also you can use this software. So this is related to your computer engineers or electronic engineers about where these applications you can use. Okay. So these are the points that I have already discussed with you about this universal language. Here I have used this term universal language. Okay, because I want to put this term inside your mind. Okay, whenever you heard about this engineering graphics, engineering drawing, in some universities it is called as engineering drawing also. Okay, so wherever you heard of this term engineering graphics, engineering drawing, rather many universities, those are following engineering drawing, they are using conventional modes of drawing using pencils and drafters. Okay, now I'll show you what is this drafters and conventional mode of drawings. But here we are trying to club your conventional engineering drawing with the recent trends of the demands that is in the market, that is your softwares available, and we have clubbed this to make this subject graphics design and modeling. Okay, so wherever you heard of this term, GDM, graphics, drawing, the first term that you should come in your mind is your universal language. You can say this is a universal language that can be used to convey my idea or concept, whatever it is there on a piece of paper. So whatever the points we have discussed till now, I have summarized over here. Okay. Again, different versions or different licenses are there. Okay, AutoCAD architectural planning are there. It can be used as a drafting tool, graphic design tool, even in 3D printing. Nowadays, the recent trends in your engineering stream is 3D printing, 3D component printing of any component. Okay, so there also this AutoCAD can be used. It can be used in fashion industry. It can be used in any industrial design tools as well. Okay, so these are the different applications that I have taken from that AutoCAD software websites. So again, to summarize, the purpose of engineering drawing is to document or to communicate the work created by engineers and designers. The drawing shows the technical details of structure and machine or other engineering projects, so that knowledgeable people can build it or understand its function. Here I have used this term, knowledgeable person. Knowledgeable person means the person who is having the knowledge to read the drawing, to interpret what it is, and to understand its function. Okay, that's why I have used this term, knowledgeable. Okay, to understand a technical drawing, you need knowledge to exactly what one represents. Even if you are not an engineer, you need to know about structural, steel construction, machine design, electrical components, or any technical details. These things we have already discussed, so no need to go in detail about that. Okay, coming to the size of papers. Okay, we all have seen this A4 size paper. I will show you one piece of paper. It is there in my desk. The normal paper that we use for printing day-to-day things, okay, or Xerox page, this is your A4 size paper. This is called as your A4 size paper. Okay, this is the dimension of it. The dimension here you can see 210 mm into 297 mm. Okay, so on which side it will be 210 mm, on which side it will be 297? It is very clear from the figure only you can see here. This will be your 210 and the length along the length, it is 297 mm. Okay, what if I will fold it from the middle like this?
A2.
I have folded. Now you can see this is the half of your A4 size paper. I have folded it. This was your real paper. This is your half of paper. This is your A5 size. This is called as A5 size. Here you can see. At the top, it is starting with A5. It is the half of your A4. Okay. For better visibility, I am changing the color for all the sizes. So A4 I am representing, it is just the double of your A5. So this green color is representing the A4 size of the sheet. One student has written, not clear, sir. What is not clear? My voice is not clear or the concept is not clear? Voice is not coming clear. Okay, wait for one minute. I was using a
bracelet.
I'll replace it with the wired one.
నేను చేస్తున్నా నాకు
దట్ బ్లూటూత్ ఇష్యూ ఇట్ వాస్ కమింగ్
అయిపోయింది పెట్టేసావా ఏంటి నీ ఇష్టం మీరు అయిపోయిందా పెడదాం అంటున్నా
Yeah, now I am using this wired headphone. I hope now the voice is coming clearly. Mute yourself, I can hear some disturbing noises coming. Until or unless it is not required, don't unmute yourself. Okay. Yeah. Now tell me whether the voice is coming clear or not.
Yes, sir.
Clear now?
Yes, sir. Yes,
okay.
Sir.
Okay, very good. Like this, if required, you can unmute yourself and you can speak it out. Okay. So we were discussing about the paper size. Okay, so you have seen what is A5 size, you have seen an example of your A4 size also. Okay, now what will happen if I'll double it from this line? If I'll double it, like here this half size paper was there and I have opened it, so it becomes a full size A4 paper. Now if I'll add one more page or one more sheet on this side, suppose I'll paste this paper along this length. Okay. So what you will obtain, that size is A3 size. Okay. Let me show you on this diagram also with black color. This will be your A3 size. As you can see here,
The projections are also drawn for each and every papers with this dash lines. Okay. When you will double A4, you will get A3. Okay. The dimensions you can see here, 297 mm to 420 mm. Now, when you will double it with this length, if you will double it again, if you will open it along this length, okay, you will obtain this size paper whose dimension is 420 into 594. Okay, so this will be your A2 size paper. Okay, again, after this, if you will double it again from this side along this length, okay, you will get the paper of length A1. And again, if you will double it along this length, you will get the paper of size A0. This is the full length paper. Somewhere, if the big buildings are there, their drawings are represented on this A. The drawings were represented on this A0 size paper, whose dimension is given as 841 mm into 1189 mm. Now, what is the special significance for this? I'll tell you. If I'll ask you, what is the area of this paper? Area of this paper, this A0, you do your calculation, you know how to calculate the area of a rectangle, and type the answer in the chat box. What you are getting? Dimension here it is written, 841 into 1189. You multiply it. It is in mm, you can convert it into meters also. If you will convert it into meter, it will become 0.841 mm. And this will become 1.189 meter. If I'll convert it into meter, so it will become 0.841 meter into 1.189 meter. Now multiply this and what you are getting, type in the chat box. Numerical value. Okay, don't tell me it will become A3 or A4. Okay, numerical value. You have to just multiply 0.841 into 1.189. Yes, one student has written it, 0.999. After decimal, see here, 9 is coming 4 times, means it is almost equals to 1. So the area of this A4 size paper, A0 full size paper is 1 meter square. Keep in your mind. Okay, the area of this A0 paper is 1 meter square, whose dimensions will be 841 mm and 1189 mm. Okay, so this is just for your knowledge. I told you, maybe it can be asked in your viva examination. Okay, so here it is tabulated basically. What are the different sizes of the paper along with their dimension, we have already seen in the previous figure. Now coming to different types of lines, I hope you have gone through these different type of lines in the last class. Okay, once again I will show you with example. I will show you what are the different types of lines, where it is used in your drawing. Okay, so some of the lines you can see here on your screen is construction lines, center line. You can see the difference. It is discontinuous, the center line. A long line, then a short dash. Again, a long line, then a short dash. Again, a long line, then a short dash. This is your center line. This is called as hidden line, dash lines. Where these hidden lines will be used, that I will tell you. But these are equally spaced dash lines. Excuse me. So these are the different types of lines: construction line, center line, hidden line, break line, dimension line. We will see all of them one by one. Short break line, cutting plane, section line. Okay, with example, we will see all of them. Let's see it. Suppose here you have some drawing on the middle one. On the middle column, you can see some drawing is there. For this case, I am encircling it so that you can easily understand of what I am talking about. Here you have a drawing. The outer edges, the outer lines, it is represented using visible line, visible thick lines, rather I can say. It should be clearly visible. Okay, so this is where we use your visible thick lines, the outer lines. Okay, hidden lines. Hidden lines, as I have told you in the previous slide, that it is represented using dashed lines. Equally spaced dash lines. Here you can see some measurement is also written, what is its length and what is that length, but no need to remember those things. You just keep in mind that this is your dash line, which is used to represent the hidden line. Now, what is hidden line? Let me explain you with some example. Let me see what is there with me. Yeah, I have a textbook in my hand. Okay, you can see this is as a automobile engineering, one book is there. Okay, this is, if you will talk about the shape of this book, this is a rectangular book. Okay, continuous surface is there. Suppose I'll make a hole at the center of this book. Suppose I will make a hole at the center of this book so that we can see throughout from this side to the that side. Okay. If you look this book from this side, will you be able to see that hole? Yes or no? Tell me.
No, sir.
You will not be able to see that hole, but the hole is there. Okay. So how to represent that hole in a drawing? For that, we need these hidden line or your dash lines. Okay. Using this hidden line, we use to represent the lines which are actually there, but we are not able to see it because they are hidden. Okay, so this is your dashed lines used to represent the hidden lines. Keep in your mind, this is very important question for your external Viva exam. What are the different type of lines? Okay, so you should simply know how it is represented and where it is used. That's it. Now, section line. Section line, here you can see some hatchings are there. Hatching means some inclined lines, you are able to see that. Okay, for those lines, let me change the color. Yeah, here you can see some inclined lines, they are at certain angle. They are used to represent the cut section. Suppose this is the book and I had made a small chunk at this portion, at this corner, I had made a small cut, a rectangular cut. Like whenever you cut the cake for your birthday, na, you make a small slice cut out. So some sections that are visible, you can see on the cake surface, inside cut surface. How to represent those cut sections in your engineering drawing? Okay, for that, we use these section lines. Here you can see they are thin lines. Okay, you can see it is not as darker as this thick line. It is thin line and it is inclined to represent the cut portion or the section component of anything. It can be machine or your cake also. Okay, so this is the section line. It is thin. Center line, wherever there is any circle, okay, as I have told you in taking the example of this book, that if I'll make a hole inside it, how I will represent it. So here I have shown you that its length, along the length, you can see the hidden lines from this side. It will be represented by your dash lines. But wherever there is any circular component, any circle, as you can see here in this diagram, a circle is here. wherever there is any circle, you have to represent, sew its center. Okay, so for sewing the center, you need to intersect two lines. Okay, so that is called as center line. Whenever there is line passing through the center of any circle, this is represented by this long continuous and then one short line is there. Again, there will be long continuous and it is also thin. It is not as dark as your visible thick lines. So this is another type, that is your center line. Okay, likewise, we have some other lines also. If you want to give some dimension, here you can see the dimension of one component is drawn. So to represent that dimension, how you sew its representation? I want to sew the length of this component. Length means this red color. Suppose I am making one arrow also. This length I want to sew. How much is the length of this component? Okay. How much is the length of my mobile phone from this end to this end? What is the length? Okay. So to represent that length on a 2D piece of paper, we need to give the dimension. Here it is written some 3 fraction 3 by 8. Okay. It can be some decimal or it can be some integer number also. So to represent that, we need to draw dimension line. Dimension. For representing the dimension, we need to draw an extension line. This is called as extension line. The one I have drawn in green color. Okay. That is called as extension line. I'm extending what? I'm extending the length which I want to sew its measurement. Okay. And then we can give the dimension line like this. At the center, we can write what is that value is. And at the both ends, you need to draw an arrow. Okay. In drawing that arrow also, in engineering drawing, there is some special criteria. Like suppose I'm zooming that arrow here. On the right hand side, you can see on the screen. Suppose this is the arrow, it will be completely filled. Okay, so if you will see, there is ratio. There is some ratio also. What will be the length to height ratio? Okay, suppose this height is 1 unit. Okay, so its length should be 3 units. Suppose this is 1 mm. Suppose this is one, the height of this arrow is 1 mm. So the length of this arrow should be 3 mm. This is the specification standard codes of our BIS, Bureau of Indian Standards. Okay, so these things you keep in your mind. Okay. For arrow, this is the standard way to draw an arrow. And this is how we draw the dimension line or extension line. So what is the extension line? The length that we are extending and we want to represent, we extend it. So this is your extension line. And the line which is we are using to write down the dimension of it, this is your dimension line. So this is how a dimension line is represented. Okay. Now there are many other lines also, all the lines it is not useful, but still I will tell you some of them. Suppose this is how to represent the cutting plane. Okay, short breaks. Suppose I have, this is solid. It is not a hollow bottle. Suppose something solid is filled inside it and I want to sew what is inside it. So I want to cut this small portion. I'll cut a small portion of this bottle to show you what is inside it. So this is how we are representing this with using short break lines. In drawing, suppose certain situation is arising where long dimension is to be represented. At that location, we need to have this long break lines that is represented like this. It is somewhat looking like your ECG of a medical device. Okay, so this is your long break line where we have to represent the long dimensions. Like this, there are many dimensions. So you need to keep in your mind what is this visible thick line, hidden line, what is section line, what is center line, okay, and dimension line. These are important. these type of lines and how it is used, you must keep in your mind. Okay, this is regarding the type of lines used in your engineering graphics, or you can say engineering drawing, or you can say GDM. Okay, so questions can be asked like, discuss the different type of lines, explain the application of each line types in technical drawing. Okay, so basically these are your Viva questions. Someone is asking something. 148 double means we get 296, but the dimension of A4 is given 297. Is it correct, sir? Okay, someone is asking some question. I have seen just now in the chat box. 148 double means 296. Oh, it is regarding the size of the paper. Okay, you can do it experiment practically. Okay, suppose you take one A4 size paper. It must be at your home. Okay. You can see in the graphic representation also I have shown here. Yeah. Here in this slide you can see this is your A4 size paper. I hope it is visible on your screen. Okay. It is represented here in this figure. See the green color. I am overwriting it with your red color. Okay, now using black, I'm showing you this side. It is your 210 and this is your 297. Okay, if you will keep a mirror over here across this line, you will get same as it is on this side also, mirror image. That is drawn over here. Okay, that is just below it. You can see this A3 size. Okay, just doubling it along this length. Okay, so which length will be doubled? This will stay remain. This will remain as it is 297, but this is your 210. So it will become now double. 210 will become 420. So it is your 420 and the length is your 297. Likewise, now I'm keeping the mirror plane over here. So you will get a mirror image of this A3. I'm showing it with the green color. So you will get exact replica on this side also. Now, which dimension you are doubling? This dimension you are doubling, okay? So this is what dimension? This is your 297. So now it is becoming 594. Okay, so you have to just fold it like this. I will show you, very simple. If this is your A5, okay, A5 size, this paper, this is your 210, this is 148. Now open this. This will become your A4. This is your 297, 210. Open this. This is the mirror line. This is the mirror plane where I am opening it. It will become A3. Once again, if you will open it, it will become A2, like this. If you will again open it along this, it will become A0. So this is regarding the size of the paper. Okay. Here the dimensions are also written. This is just for your knowledge. Now I hope it is clear to you. So where we were discussing, we have seen different type of lines. Geometric nomenclature. Now we will see. We have seen the definition of what is point, what is line, what is angle, what are the different type of angles. Also, you have seen 180 degrees there, it means straight line, 90 degrees there, right angle line, acute angle, less than 90, obtuse angle, greater than 90. Okay, likewise, you have complementary angle, supplementary angle, means summation will be together 180 or summation will be 90 degree. These are the different angles that can be used in your geometric drawings. If you will talk about the triangles, if all the sides are equal, we will call it as equilateral triangle. If two sides lengths are equal, it is isosceles, scalene, and right angle triangle, you will see with 90 degree. These all things you might have studied in your intermediate, in your coordinate geometry. Quadrilateral will be having four sides. In quadrilateral, if the lengths are equal, all angles are 90 degree, it will be your square. Okay, If opposite sides are equal, it is rectangle. Likewise, you have seen rhombus, rhomboid, trapezoid, trapezium. More than four sides, it will become polygon. Okay, three sides, triangles, four sides, square, pentagon, five sides, six sides, hexagon. Okay, seven sides, heptagon, like that. This is circle. In circle, you can see some specifications here like diameter. What is diameter? Diameter is the straight distance from one outside curved portion to the center point. Here you have, suppose, center point. Okay, so this is the longest line that we can draw connecting the opposite points and your center point. Okay, likewise, you have the radius. This is the chord. This is the arc. What is segment, sector? You can see these pictures are clearly depicting you. Okay. One thing here you can see what is concentric circle. The circles having different diameter, but if their centers are coinciding, that is your concentric circle. If their centers are eccentric, means they are not coinciding, there is some distance between them, that is called as your eccentric circle. Okay, you can see tangent, you can see secant. Okay, so this is regarding your circle. There are some solid primitives. Okay, basically normally we use these prism and your pyramids. Okay, now what is the difference between prism and pyramid? Can anyone tell me? Yeah, can anyone tell me what is the difference between this prism and pyramid? The figure is in front of you. Okay, here also you can see on the right hand side all type of your pyramids and prisms are there. Okay, this is your right triangular prism, right square prism, oblique pentagonal. Likewise, you have here prisms, all prisms, right square, right rectangular, oblique rectangular. What is the one basic difference, you tell me, just based on the appearance, what you can observe on the screen? I want to know the difference between prism and pyramid. Anyone in the class? It has four triangles. Okay, for what, prism or pyramid? One basic difference is there. One very simple, very simple. Try to answer it. Take 1 or 2 minute time. Okay, pyramid has one base, prism has two bases. Very good. 1104, very good. Here we can see in the case of prism, this is also prism. Okay, this is right triangular prism. What you can observe, there are two parallel surfaces. See here on the screen. One triangle is there at the top, one triangle is there at the bottom. Yeah. Here you can see two triangular surfaces, two parallel triangular surfaces, rather I can say, they are connected with some rectangular faces here. For rectangular face, I will use some other color for better clarity. Okay. Those two triangular parallel surfaces we are connecting with the help of rectangles. Okay, and this is that rectangle. Rectangular face is there. Okay, on this side also you have, they are connected. So two parallel faces are connected using rectangular faces. This we have observed in the case of your prism. Now, what is the case for your pyramid? Here you can see there is one base. Okay, and the corners of this base, whether it is a triangle or a rectangle or a square, anything, okay, all the corners are connected at the top with one point only. That is called as the vortex. They all are connected to the top, okay, with one, at one point only, okay. And here, what are the connecting faces? Here, the connecting faces is triangular in nature. This you can see here, they are triangular. Okay, so this is the pyramid. Why I have asked you this question, you must keep in your mind, because it can be asked in your viva examination. What is the difference between prism and what is the difference between pyramid? Later when we will see, as I have shown you in your syllabus, in one slide I have shown you your syllabus, solids, projections of solids in simple position. Okay, in that chapter we will go in detail about what is this prism and what is this pyramid. Okay, how the orientations are drawn. Okay, all the details we will see in that unit. So just keep in your mind, I'm giving the basics of all the units, a glimpse of everything. Okay, so this is about your solid. There are some ready-made primitives available in the software also. Sphere, torus, ellipsoid. Okay, so these, some of the basic primitive solids will be ready-made available in your AutoCAD software. Now, how to use those things to build any component, we will come to that later in the classes. Now, equipments for engineering drawing. As I have told you, in many universities, this term is engineering drawing. In all IITs and NITs, they are following this term engineering drawing, and they are teaching you only the conventional mode of drawing anything. Okay, using your big drawing boards, drawing sheets. Okay, drawing sheets, drawing board, mini drafter, T-square. These are different instruments, compass, divider, set square, protector. I will just show you so that it will be in your mind how they looks like. Okay, and nowadays they are becoming obsolete because of the softwares available in the market. They are very helpful, but you should know what are these components, how to use that. Okay, so I will just show you what are those. This is the drawing sheet. We have already talked about the size of your papers. Someone has unmuted. Please mute yourself. Okay. We have one drawing board like this, okay, which will be held on some tripod or some table or stool. Okay, this is called as mini drafter. You all must see this. In earlier days, it is called as the weapon of an engineer. Okay, the first year students normally call it as the weapon of an engineer. This is very useful instrument to draw parallel lines, perpendicular lines, or angles at any lines at any angles. Here some markings are there to draw on this circular portion. You can see some markings are there. This portion is fixed on your drawing board, and this portions, these linkages, these steel linkages you can see here, using this, these are the perpendicular lines, and on the outer portion, different angles are noted. Using that, you can draw lines of perpendicular, parallel, or any angles. Okay, this is called as mini drafter. This is your T-square. This is compass. You all know these things. This is your protector and set squares. This is new for you people, I guess. This is called as your French curve. Many times we need to connect two points, giving them some curve. Okay, suppose I am drawing something. This is my first line and this is my second line. So I have two points here. This is point number one. This is point number two. I want to connect them. Okay, if you have a scale with you, you can draw a straight line and connect it. Okay, if you have to give some curve in between these two points, okay, curve can be anything. It can go in second order, it can go in third order. Okay, it can go in any way. Okay, so how to connect those two points? Using this French curves, you can connect those points. Okay, wherever, in which slope you want, using those slopes, we use this French curve and connect those two points. So this is, I think, new equipment for you people. So you can keep this in your mind. This is called as French curve. Pencils. different pencils are there. Suppose I will keep my pointer at this location, that is your HB pencil. You can see it on your screen. Okay. HB pencil, normally what we use for our day-to-day life. If you will go on the right-hand side, H pencil, 2H pencil, 3H, 4H, 5H, 6H, it will be dimmer, 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 dimmer. Okay. Means the line will be, you will get thin, 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 thin. If you will go on this left-hand side, B, 2B, 3B, 4B, 5B, it will be darker, 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 like that. Here you can see. So for darker line, that graphite must be soft in nature so that you can get darker line. Okay, now you can think like an engineer also. Why for few pencils we are getting thin lines and why for few pencils we are getting darker lines? Okay, this is the mindset of an engineer, that questioning. Why? How? Okay, so what is happening to this H, 2H, 3H? It is becoming harder, 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 and this 6H, okay, this will be extremely hardest. If it is hard, it will be difficult to draw on the piece of the paper. So you are getting thin lines. Okay, and if that inside black material, that is basically graphite, carbon, okay, if it is softer in nature, okay, then you will be able to get thick lines. Okay, so this is the softest pencil available. So this is the difference. How, if somewhere you need to draw thin lines, which pencil to use? If you need to draw thick lines, which pencil to use? Normally, in general purpose, up till now, you might be using only HB pencil. Okay, so in engineering drawing, basically H and 2H pencils are preferred. Okay, so this is regarding your pencils. Lettering, earlier it is discussed, there are certain way, there are certain rule, how to write any alphabet. Like here on the screen, you can see letter A is written, G is written, O, O, D. Okay. Likewise, there are certain rules how to write these things. So this is the way of lettering. Every first exercise that is given to any student is to practice this, how to write any letter in engineering drawing. Okay. So if it would be your physical classes, then I might told you to write this line that I have written here. A good draftman will never letter without guidelines. Okay, so those guidelines, these lighter lines you can see, yeah, these are basically the guidelines. And what you have written in the thick, it is your original letter that you have written. So these are the way how to write in engineering drawing. You can see any engineering drawing in any factory or in industry, they must follow these patterns. Okay, so this is regarding the introduction to your engineering graphics. Okay, what is engineering drawing? Okay, what are the different types of lines? What are the different size of papers? What are the different components or instruments that we use for your drawing? What is your course outcome? We have seen your syllabus. We have seen few examples for different domains of the engineering. Okay, so this is regarding the introduction to the subject. Now, as I have told you earlier, we will see the theory of projection. Okay, so today I will start theory of projection now. I hope, is there any confusion what we have discussed till now? Then you can ask me if there is anything that you want to ask. However, this I am taking as a recap class, so I hope there will not be any that much of doubt. If still you have any doubt, you can ask me. After this, we will start your orthographic projection or the theory of projections. Okay. Whether this is visible to all of you, the topic that is written here, I have changed the slide. Orthographic projection is now coming onto the slide. Can you see this on your screen? Projections. If it is visible to you, type in the chat box. VS, visible, sir. You can type the short form, VS. Okay, very good. Let me see how many of you are actively listening. All of you write VS, visible, sir. Type V and S. Let me see how many of you are actively listening. We have now 56 participants. I want 56 response. Fast. Okay, very good. Good to see that all the students are actively listening. Okay. This is also a source of energy for a teacher. If a student is listening properly and whatever the message that I want to convey to you people, if you are receiving it in a proper way, then the system will operate in a normal way. Okay. Even the efficiency will increase. Okay. So now we are going to start with the new topic, that is your projections. Now, what is projection? First, you need to understand what is projection. A figure is in front of you on your slide. Okay, just have a watch on this. Take some time. I'm giving you 1 minute time and think what this figure wants to tell you. Then we will discuss on it. Now anyone students who wants to speak, just tell me what this figure is depicting. You can unmute yourself. One student, one by one. Yeah, anyone? One student is written, watching TV with some distance. Okay. Any other opinion? Any other students? Projector, you must have seen all of you. Projector in your classroom or any office. Okay. You must have seen this project, even in your theater. One of the student has written, in theater or cinema hall, we used to project, okay, on the screen. There will be one big screen, okay. So this is your, that big screen. And here in technical language, we call it as the plane of projection, where your movie is projected from the backside, okay. When you will go in any multiplex, you will see from the backside something is projected on that big screen, okay? Or even in your classes there is some projector hanged on, in the wall, and it is projecting something on your screen, okay? So basically it is a projector screen. In technical language, we call it as plane of projection, okay? And that source of projection, okay, here you can see one person is standing over here. This is the observer. This is the observer. In technical language, we call it as observer. Let me take a red color. It will increase the visibility. That person is looking one object. One object is here. One object. I'm highlighting it in red color. Okay, now what you can see, the eyesight of this person, some lines are going, okay? Some lines are going, person's eye. Line of sight, it is passing through the corners or the edges of this object and it is getting projected on your screen. Okay, it is getting projected on your. Likewise, this line of sight or the projector, or one more term I will say, projection lines. This is the glare that I have drawn here. Let me draw other also. For clear understanding, you should understand what is this line of sight, that is called as projectors, that is also called as line of projection. So this green color lines that you can see here is your light or the line of projector. Suppose for one real example to show you, okay, here I have a mobile phone in my hand. All the mobile phones have flashlight. I have switched on this flashlight. Okay, on you can see on the backside due to reflection, some of the light is your black screen also. Okay, or suppose any component I will keep in between, this is transparent. I have to keep, suppose I have keep some what we call object over here, its shadow will be formed on my computer screen. This is, you are looking on this slide. Okay, this is the light of source. Here is the light of source or the observer's eye, from where this light is passing through the edges or the corners of all the corner object, and it is getting projected on the screen here. Okay, so this is called as your projection. That projection is coming on the plane of projection here. Point what is to be noted here is, those line of projections or the line of sight is coming from a single point. All the light rays, like my flashlight of the mobile on the backside, it is originating from the flash point of my camera. Okay, here, this is a single point. So all the light rays are originating from a single point. Now, another case, what I want to show you, when I will keep the light source very far away from the object, very far away. Like you can see our sun, it is a very far location from us. We can call it near to infinite from, okay, it is very far away. We can say it is at some infinite distance. So when the light source will be coming from a very large distance, and it will fall on some object, okay, then what is the difference for this case and the case that you have seen on your computer screen? Difference will be here for the second case, when the light source is coming from infinite distance, the lines will be parallel to the lines, the rays will be coming parallel to the line or edges of your object. Okay, here it is originating from one point, and for that case, the lines will be parallel. Here they all are intersecting at one point. Okay, so that's why you are getting here some enlarged view. The size of the object that you can see here, here you are getting an enlarged view. The size is a little bit bigger. Okay, but when the light source will come from an infinite distance, okay, so what will happen? Parallel lines will come, and the image that you will get on the plane of projection, technical language I'm using, plane of projection, okay, not on the screen, I'm using plane of projection, you will get the image or view of exactly the same size, what is the size of the object, same size, the inside figure that you can see that what I am drawing here. So this is the two difference we will see in detail. Okay, just keep in your mind what I have given you. For clarification, here I have used plane of projection. The term I was using, plane of projection. Now the question is, what is plane? What is plane? Okay, so try to understand here in the figure, it is also drawn. And I would like to show you one example also. Again, this book is with me. So I will take the example of this book, and one board is here with me. Okay. This is the digital board that I'm using. Okay. So I have disconnected it. Suppose this, I'm keeping it horizontal. Horizontal means parallel to the floor surface, parallel to the table surface. This is horizontal and this is your vertical. Okay. This I have kept vertical. So now I have one set of perpendicular planes. One is horizontal and the second one, this book, textbook, automobile engineering. This is the vertical. Okay. So this set of plane is what represented here in this figure. As you can see here, one is written VP. VP stands for vertical plane. Okay. The second one that you can see is your HP, horizontal plane, the board that I was using, that was representing the horizontal book I was using, that is your vertical plane. Okay. So what are the different type of planes you see here? So the first one we have seen vertical plane, the second one we have seen horizontal plane. These two are called as principal planes. Okay. These two are called as principal plane. Okay. What are principal planes? In your viva, if it is asked what is principal plane, you have to tell horizontal plane and vertical plane. Okay. Now the second type of plane will come, you can see here on the scalary plane. Two main type of planes, it is written in pink color, principal plane and auxiliary planes. Okay. So what is auxiliary plane? Here you can see in between this set of perpendicular planes, that is your vertical plane represented by VP and horizontal plane represented by HP. Okay. One extra plane is coming into the picture, that is your auxiliary vertical plane. I'll try to explain you with example also. Okay. If you are able to see what, on the screen, if you can see, this black color board is my horizontal plane and this book is my vertical plane. This angle, the angle between this book and this blackboard, okay, is 90 degree. One another plane I am bringing into the picture, this, my mobile phone. My mobile phone I am keeping in this position. The same color is coming now. Oh, black, black, it is creating some issue. Okay, let me open it. I am opening this book. Okay, this is your horizontal plane, this is your vertical plane. Now, this black color mobile phone, I am keeping it like this. Okay. I hope it is visible to you on this video screen. Now you can see this angle, the angle which this mobile surface is making with this horizontal surface. What is that angle? This angle? This surface is making an angle 90 degree because it is kept vertically on this plane, na? This is making an angle of 90 degree with horizontal plane. Okay. But what about the case of this vertical plane? What is this angle? The angle made with this vertical plane, it is making some angle. Okay. This is what pictorially I have tried to show you on this presentation slide. This figure. Focus on this figure. Okay. With these two slides, I will end the class. Don't worry. Okay. So you need to focus what I'm telling you, because this is the basic fundamentals of your projection of planes. Okay. After in the next session, we will go in detail about the projection of planes. Just you focus what are planes. So auxiliary vertical plane. You can see here, it is showing in green color. This symbol you can see here, one horizontal line and one vertical line. It is showing the symbol of perpendicularity. Symbol of perpendicularity means this plane, which is represented here with green color, is perpendicular to HP. What is meant by HP? It is horizontal plane, okay? So it is perpendicular to horizontal plane, but it is making some angle. This is representing the symbol of your angle, okay? It is making some angle with BP. What is BP? BP is vertical plane. So that angle is represented here with angle phi. In the figure you can see here, it is written phi. This is your auxiliary vertical plane. Okay. So to summarize, in one line I can say that this green color plane that you can see here in this figure, it is perpendicular to horizontal plane and making some angle with the vertical plane. Now, come to the second figure. The second figure, auxiliary inclined plane. You see this figure and tell me what you have observed here. I want response from the students. Yeah. What you have observed in the second figure? Anyone in the class? You can type in the chat box, or you can. Yes, very good. Someone has written 29, perpendicular to vertical plane. Very good. So it is now perpendicular to vertical plane and making some angle with horizontal plane. Okay. If you have any textbook or notebook with you right now, okay, that you must keep with you, then you can try it and see what this figure 2 and figure 1 is representing. Okay. So I will try to show you here again in this, taking the example of my mobile phone and the book, textbook. Okay. Once I will open this book, this is my, yeah, this is my horizontal plane, the flat surface, and this is the vertical plane. In previous case, my mobile was like this. Now, what I'm doing, I'm keeping the mobile phone like this. Now, if you look here, what is happening now, the surface, the mobile is perpendicular to the vertical plane. Okay. And it is making some angle with horizontal plane. For this case, it is lying on HP. My mobile phone, it is lying on horizontal plane. It is perpendicular to vertical plane. Okay. Now see what the changes I'm making. I'm changing the orientation. I'm little bit tilting it. Now you can see clearly in the video. Okay. My mobile phone is resting on HP on one of its side. Okay. And it is making some angle with horizontal plane. Suppose this is 45 degree. Now I'm changing the orientation like this. It is making an angle of 90 degree. This surface is making an angle of 90 degree with horizontal surface. And in the same way, this surface is making an angle 90 degree with vertical plane also. Okay, so two cases we have seen. The first case when it is perpendicular to HP, and the second case when it is perpendicular to vertical plane and making some angle with horizontal plane. These are the two cases. The third case is, see here, the third case that I have shown you here, when the mobile is held like this, perpendicular to both the planes, perpendicular to horizontal as well as the vertical plane. Okay. So the third figure that you can see here, it is represented as profile plane Okay. Here you can see the green color plane. It is the green color plane. Let me highlight it. It is perpendicular to both the planes. What are those two planes? Vertical plane and horizontal plane. So this is called as your profile plane. So these terms that we will be using when we will study the theory of projection or orthographic projection in detail. So we have seen different type of planes here. In this slide, on the different type of planes, if you have any doubt, you ask me. I'll clarify. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. You can type in the chat box if you have any issue, or you can unmute and you can speak also, but one by one. And if it is clear to all of you, sir, you explain the second option again. Okay, very good. Very good. The second figure. See here, the book is in on my hand. This is your horizontal plane. Okay, this flat surface. This is your horizontal plane. If I will open it, now you are getting both the two surfaces. This is your vertical, this is your horizontal. Unmute yourself. Someone has unmuted, mute yourself. Disturbance is created. Okay. Now, all of you, see, once again, I'm explaining you the second figure. Here, we have this vertical plane. Okay. And this one is your horizontal plane. Okay. Now, this mobile phone I am considering as your auxiliary inclined plane. Suppose here it is placed like this. Now you tell me, it is perpendicular to which plane? Yes. You can unmute yourself and tell me the answer. If I hold this vertical, I have hold this vertical. This is perpendicular to both the planes, okay? Horizontal plane as well as your vertical plane. Now, see what I'm doing. I'm changing the orientation like this. Now you tell me, is it perpendicular with VP and making some angle with your HP, or it is the case of?
Okay, sir.
Is it clear? So this is the case where it is.
Sir.
Okay. So this is the first orientation, and this is the second. This orientation. Where it is perpendicular to your vertical plane and it is making some angle with your horizontal plane. So this is the second example that you have seen here. And the third case I have told you when it is perpendicular to both the planes. This is your profile plane, okay? So these are the different planes that you will come through when we will be looking for projection of planes. Or when we will be drawing your orthographic or isometric projections. Yeah. Now you can see in two dimension, if I have to draw, see here, I'm showing it with red color. Yeah. This is my x-axis and this is my y-axis. Okay, I will write here x dash or x prime, here y and y prime. So this is which quadrant? This is quadrant number one, or we call it as first quadrant. This is your quadrant number two, or second quadrant. This is your third quadrant. And this is your fourth quadrant. I have represented it in two dimension. Whatever I have drawn here, it is in two dimension. Suppose I have to show it in three dimension. So it will look like what you can see in this figure. Okay, the line that I have drawn, this is your x, and this is your y and y prime line. It is intersecting at this point, that is the origin. And in three dimension, we call it as when we will extend it. Suppose I am extending all the lines. This is my, suppose x, and this is my x prime. If I am extending this surface, what I will get? I will get this surface. I'm highlighting it in black color. All of you pay attention on this. I'm extending the line x, x prime. Okay. When I will extend it, it is giving me the plane that is horizontal plane. Here you can see. The name of this plane, what you are getting with when I'm extending x, x prime line is, you are getting horizontal plane. Okay. Similar way, if you will extend this vertical line, the vertical line that I have drawn here as y, y prime. This is my y, this is my y prime. When I'll extend this, I'll get this plane. And from this, you will get this frontal plane, or you can call it as vertical plane. Okay. So what we have demonstrated in the previous slide, same, we are looking here in pictorial representation, 2D as well as 3D. Okay. So we will get this horizontal plane, this is your vertical plane. And the quadrants that I have represented here, first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, and fourth quadrant, exactly same it is shown over here also. Okay. If suppose this is the plane of the paper, I'm showing it in green color. This is the green color representation what I have drawn over here. Okay. In the same way, you can see this is your first quadrant, this is your second quadrant, this is your third quadrant, and this is your fourth quadrant. Okay. So this is regarding the quadrant representation, planes. Okay. Now, in the next class, we will see what will happen to the projection when the object is placed in first quadrant, when the object is placed in second quadrant, or third quadrant, or fourth quadrant. This we will see in the next class. So that's all for today's class. If you have any doubt or confusion, you can ask me. And if it is clear to all of you, then you can type clear, sir, CS. C stands for clear, S stands for sir. Clear, sir. CS, type in your chat box. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. Good to see that it is clear to all of you. Very good. In the next class, we will see the different angle of projection method, that is first angle projection method, and third angle projection. With this, I'm going to stop the class. All the best and have an energetic Monday.